Hi there, I'm Laurenzio, and in this video I'm going to talk about All Naruto Games for the 360 and PS3. Enjoy the video! Naruto Rise of Ninja is the first Naruto game on the new generation consoles. This game was released only on the 360. This is a 360 exclusive, it was never released on the PS3. Neither Rise of Ninja nor the next game, Broken Bond. And I have to say that the game started on the right foot, though it has some stuff to improve. First off, it's awesome that you get free roam, and you have the map of Konoha and part of its surroundings to roam in. But even if it's awesome that you get free roam, the missions you get while in the free roam are repetitive and they get annoying at some point. Most of them revolve around collecting stuff, or getting stuff from one point of the map to the other. You get some weird tree climbing minigame, the battle system feels okay, it's not as fast paced and epic as it will get in the later titles, and jutsus are harder to pull off, but still, the fighting part of the game as a whole is solid. And it's satisfying too. And for that time, the combat was the best out of all of the Naruto games until then. It gets dull and repetitive, but still, it was a good start on the new consoles. And having free roam in a Naruto game was something wow at that time. It covers the first 80 episodes of the anime, and it's the first Naruto game that combines free roam with fighting mechanics. The free roam is clunky, it gets better the more you play, but even if it gets better after you get used to the controls, they still remain clunky. And you will notice the finicky controls, especially when you see what platforming you have to do in the game, throughout the whole playthrough. But at least it's nice that story-wise it includes scenes from the anime, which are well put together so that it feels just right along with the fighting or racing around and fighting. Naruto Broken Bond is the follow-up of Rise of Ninja, it even uses the same engine. The game adds way more gameplay mechanics and content than Rise of Ninja, but overall, it's a mixed bag. You get to love and hate the game at the same time. In some portions of the game, you feel like the game is low budget, or that it's dull. Then the game gets promising, just to get dull again. On paper, the game is fantastic, it's varied. You solve different puzzles by switching characters, you have these sandbox areas from the Naruto world, and you don't play just with one character, but with 30 characters. And many of these characters are integrated into the story. Each one has a special ability that allows you to progress in the sandbox areas. Also, there are portions where you have to switch characters in order to solve puzzles. The battle system is weird. I don't like the joystick combinations you have to do for jutsus, but it makes sense, most of the characters are genin, thus it's hard for them to pull off lots of jutsus. But like this, the combat remains just some kicks and punches and two jutsus when you get the chance to perform them. But at least when you get the chance to pull off a jutsu, it's usually a quick time event, and it's pretty epic, so it's hard to land a jutsu, but when you do, you feel rewarded for it. Then come the environments. They look great and very detailed, but on the other hand, some level design choices got in the way from time to time. On the map part of the game, it's nice that you also get Konoha to free roam in. An annoying aspect of the game was the repetitiveness. You had lots of fetch quests to do, and even if the characters have different abilities, doing almost the same thing with each one of them made the game lose its charm. I mean, even if each character has different abilities, and each one is unique, thus you get unique puzzles with each character in particular, the game still felt repetitive. And the running minigame is weird. It might look cool on video, but I found it weird when I played it. Okay, so this was solely my opinion. Now the opinion of the reviewers is that the game is great, giving it around 8 out of 10. And the opinions were all in favor of the game. But me, as I said, I have mixed feelings about the game. It's good and dull at the same time. But even so, I can't deny that it's a big improvement over its predecessor, and that at the time it was released, it was one of the best Naruto games out there. Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm is a good start on the new generation consoles, but it still has much to improve. The combat is solid, they finally nailed the combat mechanics. You get an attack button, dash combinations, you can use substitutes, ultimate jutsus, normal jutsus, and you can even use items like ramen or others to boost your health. Or you can use shuriken, paper bombs. The combat is fast paced and just awesome. Also, the story is the one from the anime and has some touching voice acting. And the nice music will get you. The story is, being the one from the anime, the best from any fighting game I've played. The only problem I have with the game is that before getting into this badass moments, you have to do some tedious roaming around. It's nice that you get a one-to-one scaled Konoha, and that the free roam mechanics, the platforming, is way better than in any Naruto game until now. But exploring feels clunky. The camera never feels satisfying, you can only jump and throw yourself, and for example, if you want to run on buildings, you can do that only when you see this wooden planks on a building. Naruto learned to focus his chakra in his feet, but apparently he can do it only on wooden planks in the game. You need to throw shuriken at lamps and other destructible objects to collect money, and before you can enter a certain story mission, you need to grind for XP, or perform other annoying tasks like needing to walk a certain amount of steps before entering a boring mission to gain XP. Which means that if you want a piece of the game's awesome part, to do main missions, you need to roam around with the clunky exploration controls, then do some boring missions, and repeat the process until you have enough XP to finally get to a story part. For Naruto fans, the game is a good start, it's playable, but I wouldn't recommend non-fans to play the game, and even some Naruto fans might find it annoying. Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 2 brings the trademark fighting style unique to the Naruto series finally to a form that feels very similar to what we have today. The fights are finally epic, snappy, and a lot of fun. You can dash, use substitutions, jutsus are easier to perform, ultimate jutsus likewise, and in boss battles, you get quick time events that make the battles 100 times more epic. Also, the boss battle cutscenes are altered. The developers didn't just copy the animations from the anime and translated them into the 3D graphics the game uses. The battles unfold in a different fashion, in many cases to such degree that you start arguing which fight was better, the one in the game or the one in the anime. Aside of battles, you will also roam the map, which consists of sandbox areas. You don't get the free roam you saw in previous games. This game has only sandbox areas. You get a big map, but the map is split into sections and narrow passages. You can collect stuff on the ground. It's optional, but useful. From collected items, you can create new battle items, or you can sell the collected items for money, and with the money you can buy more items or unlockables like art styles, music or cutscenes, and the main story takes you around 12 hours to finish. The main story is epic, and in my opinion, it's well balanced. You get battles and sandbox parts. The sandbox parts aren't really something, but they do well to let you breathe within the battles. But if you want to do the extras, and if you want 100% completion in the game, you're in for a lot of grinding. Side quests are stupid. In one of them, you need to buy 10 items from the shop and then return to the guy that gave you the task. That's it. Or, for example, another task is that you have to find Konohamaru that hides. He hides in just in theory, because when you go out of the passage where you will normally get out of the passage, he appears in front of you. Or another annoying task is catching pigeons. It all feels like grinding. The map seems small at first, but if you're willing to do the grinding after you finish the game, you realize that the map is huge, even if it's just a bunch of sandbox areas. Oh, and the character speed is slow, which makes the huge map more annoying. I wish you could unlock a sprint button at the end of the game. It would have made things easier. Also, you have some form of fast travel, the warp scroll. It's annoying to think that after you finish the game, you can't even fast travel without paying for it. You need to buy warp scrolls in order to fast travel. So basically, the main game is well balanced and fun, but if you're going for the 100% completion, you're going to do a lot of grinding. But if you just want to play the story, as I said, it's well balanced and it will keep you interested for 12 hours. In Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 3, you can see some improvements over its predecessor. Storm 2 and 3 are very similar, but still, the improvements in Storm 3 make the experience better. First off, the one improvement that made me happy the most is that this game has far less grinding than the previous game. After you finish the story, the remaining activities are less tiresome than in the previous game. But this doesn't mean that if you want 100% completion, you won't be doing some grinding at the end of the story. No, it's just that compared to the other game, this one involves less grinding. But if you want 100% completion in the game, you are going to work for it. But luckily for you, if you don't want the 100% and you just want to play the story, then you won't encounter any form of grinding along the way. You will jump from one well-balanced thing to the other and will enjoy the epicness of the game. Also, another improvement in the free roam is that the loading times between sections take less time. In Storm 2, it wasn't a problem either because it was just a dark blink. And here the dark transition takes less time, which is an improvement. And since the whole map is a big chain of sandbox areas, this is a pretty good improvement. It's very welcomed. And the game also made the free roam parts more exciting by adding sections where you need to beat up Small Fry till you reach your destination. Story-wise, the game continues from the events from Storm 2, and even if it's split into more chapters than the previous one, Storm 3 still takes you around 11 to 12 hours to finish, same as Storm 2. In the battles, I can list some differences. The most noticeable by me is that the substitutions are significantly easier to pull off. Characters are snappier and react faster to your commands, which makes the battles faster. And another difference in the battles are the assist characters. Instead of just being assist characters like in Storm 2 and call them to attack whenever you press L1 or R1, now assist characters are of three types: attack type, defense type, and balance. And each does what the name says when you press L1 or R1. And another huge improvement is in the roster. In Storm 2, you had 40 playable characters, whereas Storm 3 doubles that and adds more characters, totaling a number of 90 playable characters. Naruto Storm Generations feels at first like it's a patched game, rather than a new entry. The first characters you play with are Naruto and Sasuke, and you've seen the stories of them in almost every game. Also, some of the pictures aren't the best. Naruto looks slightly deformed in some pictures, or others just don't look that great. Anyway, once you unlock more characters, you will see the quality of the game. The game retells the stories of several characters. It doesn't have free roam anymore. After you select a character, you get to see a cutscene, Then you get pictures with text and voiceovers telling the story, and you go from one battle to the other. Each battle is preceded and succeeded with a story element. The stories are great. They are the ones from the manga and anime, and what is great is that you get some parts that weren't in the anime or manga. After you finish the story of the character you selected, you unlock more characters. There are 12 story arcs to play. The presentation is great, and you also get usual battle modes you will see in a fighting game. Now, for a fighting game, it's amazing, as it's full of content and you don't get bored easily by the game, because it tells you a story. The combat doesn't have that much depth, there aren't as many combos as in other fighting games, but the story kind of compensates for that. The combat is fun enough, and each in-game character uses the source material with great fidelity. Compared to the other games, you now get a substitution bar. In rest, the combat is the same. More than that, the same characters from the previous Storm games have been recycled. So the game is a really great fighting game. As a Naruto game, it's again great. And in case the game will seem to you like it's just a patched game out of the first three Storm games, just wait to unlock more characters. You'll see that the game still brings new stuff, and plenty. Even if the Naruto characters and the Sasuke storyline are just a summary of the Naruto and Naruto Shippuden key moments. Just give the game a chance. The game is great. Naruto Storm Revolution intends, just like the name says, to revolutionize the series, and it succeeds. But in my opinion, its flaw is its overly ambitiousness. The gameplay has a huge deal of depth, but compared to the previous Storm games, there is a lot to pick up. In the game, you have two types of fights, one-on-ones and four-ways. In one-on-ones, you select your assist characters, and this time you have three types of them. You have the ultimate jutsu type, with which you can do ultimate jutsus. If you don't select this one, you won't be able to make ultimate jutsus, only normal jutsus. You get the awakening type, which help you awaken your character. Unless you select the awakening type, you won't be able to awaken your character like in previous iterations of the Storm series. And at last, you get the drive type, which is a mixture of two. The assist characters almost attack and defend automatically, and they don't do a great job at it. You can also seal your opponent so that it won't use any awakening or ultimate jutsus. Also in the game, if you combine certain characters, they will have a special team attack, which isn't something new, but I forgot to express it in the Storm series. And you also get two new moves, Guard Break and Counter Attack, which do exactly what the name says. In arena battles, you can see how the overly ambitiousness of the game makes the game less fun. Four characters are in a round fighting a free-for-all battle. And what is the most annoying part is that in the latter difficulties, the other three pit against you. It's not everyone for himself, it almost gets into everyone against you. I think around the B tournament it happened to me, and after that these annoying occasions were less frequent. Also, in the arena there are obstacles and ramps. And there are also awakening orbs and ultimate jutsu orbs, because you can't awaken or use ultimates unless you collect the corresponding orb. And since the battles look like a stew where everyone throws its trash in, getting the orb will be rather annoying than challenging. That's why I call the over-ambitiousness a flaw. You get flung around so much and there is so much happening on screen that it isn't fun anymore. You want to do a fancy attack? No can do, another enemy wiped you from behind. Also, the game is really easy. Even in S+, the hardest difficulty in the game, I didn't feel the challenge. Story-wise, the game is a mixed bag. The main story in the game is that the characters participate in a contest to see who's the best fighter. Sounds good. Well, the plot isn't all that exciting because you almost do the same thing for the next 20 hours. You see the boat animation, you register for the D cup or B or C or A or S, you win, you get back to the main menu, you select to continue, you get the same boat animation, but this time you participate in the next cup, which has the same procedure. You can also do challenges, which are more battles if you didn't have enough, and you can also do jobs, which are more one-on-ones and arena fights if you didn't have enough already of them. There is some variety too. You will have some fetch quests to do and scout missions to do, where you get a tip on where the enemies are and you will have to find them in the time limit, and this type of missions aren't particularly fun. They add variety, it's true, but they aren't fun. The game also has something remarkable too. For this game, around 1 hour of anime was made. Yes, was made. You get some plot lines that weren't featured in the anime, nor manga. You get the creation of the Akatsuki and the story of Shisui Uchiha, all animated and with battles in between. Now, those parts were great. They weren't repetitive, they were just exciting. And the animation in those, let's say, episodes was better than in the anime. The content is a dream for any Naruto or Naruto Storm fan. This game tops the content of all of the previous games, totaling a number of 118 playable characters, and having almost all of the battle arenas that appeared in past iterations, while also having new ones. Storm Revolution has around 33 battle stages. And let's not forget the tournaments, survival modes, and challenges, and the online feature. For a fighting game, this game packs a gigantic amount of content, and is also fun to play. It has free roam too. The only downside to the game is that without that much story, the game feels like a big grind at some point, especially if you want to get a platinum trophy. The game isn't particularly hard, but it's long. You will have to do a lot of fighting, and it will get tiresome without having a story like in Storm 1, 2 or 3. Okay, don't get me wrong. You get a lot of story in the game, just imagine that it takes you around 70 to 80 hours to finish the game, and that without 100% completion. So you get a lot of story, but compared to how many battles you get, the story isn't all that much, even if it's heavy. This doesn't mean that it's a bad game. For a fighting game, it's amazing. I was just comparing it to the others. This one has a bigger scale, but doesn't have that great balance between story, variety, and fighting. Here, you'll be fighting until you say to yourself, okay, I want to play something else. Even if you can get a fairly easy platinum out of the game, you will still get fed up by the sheer amount of battles you will have to do in this game. I mean, instead of the difficulty getting higher, the developers just added more layers to matches. If in the first tournaments you get 3 fights, in the latter tournaments you get 4 or 5 fights per tournament. This doesn't make the game any tougher, it just makes it longer. So if you intend to play all of the game's content, you will need around 90 to 100 hours. Where you'll be mostly fighting, with some very good fighting mechanics, though the overly ambitiousness of the game will probably make you want to return to Storm 3. As a conclusion, I recommend you all of the games starting from Storm 2. Sure, the games still have some flaws or drawbacks, but don't let those hinder you to try out the games. I'm doing a review. I have to say what is good and what is bad about the game, but just because I listed some downsides doesn't mean that the games are bad. On the contrary, I find the games great. Sure, they have a lot of grinding, most of them, but you can avoid the grinding in some games and get straight to the action. You have that option too, in some games. And as fighting games, they really are amazing. They are full of content, the stories are great, and the main part, the fighting, is unique and nicely done. I recommend you try out the games. Sure, I'm a big Naruto fan, of course that I like the games. I don't know if a non-fan would. I could just imagine a non-fan enjoying this series, as they are very good fighting games. So my recommendation is to try the games out and see for yourself. Oh, and if you would ask me which one of the games from this list is the best, I will definitely pick Storm 3, because it has the best balance in the main story. It has free roam that also has the small fry sections which are fun, the battles are epic, and overall it's the best balanced one. It has the best fun factor in my opinion out of all of the games from this list. If you intend to play the single player, but if you're a guy who likes online gaming, then the best online Naruto game on the PS3 and 360 is definitely Storm Revolution, because it has more content. Thus, you have more characters, more arenas to fight in. So yeah, content-wise, the best online Naruto game is Storm Revolution, and in my opinion, the best single-player experience of Naruto on the consoles is Storm 3. Okay, so this was the video. If you liked it, please hit the like button and subscribe. If you want to financially support me in my pursuit to review as many video games as possible, you can do that on Patreon or on the channel's membership section. You would help me a lot. If you want, you can follow me on Twitch, Instagram or Discord. And if you want to see another video of mine, just wait till I stop talking and there will be thumbnails of other videos I've made. Thanks for watching.